Welcome to World 1-1. We're going to examine the opening sequences from a wide range of games and look at what makes them work, or not work as the case may be. Today we're entering the shaky world of licensed games with Star Wars Shadows of the Empire and its opening level, The Battle of Hoth. This is a very strange case, where the first level is arguably the best part of the game, but doesn't really convey the game's main mechanics. In fact, there's only one other level like it, and it's the last one. In that respect, it's not a very good first level. But in terms of bringing Star Wars games into 3D, delivering an authentic experience, and just being sheer fun, The Battle of Hoth is an excellent introduction to a very memorable, but relatively average game. Now, to understand why the game begins like this, we need to look at the context. Shadows of the Empire was the first Star Wars game to enter the extended universe, and focused on events that took place outside of the films. For someone who doesn't know much about Star Wars, this could be confronting, but The Battle of Hoth provides an entry point for anyone that's ever seen Empire Strikes Back. So whether they're a casual viewer or a hardcore fan, almost anyone can get into the first level with some degree of familiarity. It also helps that the level is fairly straightforward. The lack of a time limit allows players to acclimatise to the new 3D controls, and each goal is clearly specified and segmented. Simply put, destroy the attacking Imperial forces. First the probe droids, then the AT-STs, and then finally take down the AT-ATs. The difficulty ramps up with every new objective, but succeeds in finding a sweet spot. It's not too difficult for a first level, but not so easy that you feel like you're invincible. With the smooth controls and variety of camera angles, you really feel like you're playing the movie. Using your tow cable to trip up an AT-AT can be a little bit tricky, but it feels fantastic pulling off that iconic maneuver. You're even rewarded with challenge points for defeating them in this way. The use of John Williams' original score, along with film-accurate sound effects, adds that extra touch of authenticity. There are even some fun little touches, such as your allies complaining when you shoot them, and the fact that you can down an AT-ST by kamikazing your snowspeeder. I also really appreciate that the destroyed Imperial robots don't just disappear, but instead litter the battlefield. While the Battle of Hoth shares little in common with the bulk of the game, there is one connection that is quite clever. Here in this first level, AT-STs are pretty easy to take down, just point and shoot. But at the end of level 2, when the player is on foot, a single AT-ST makes for a very challenging boss fight. It's much like a Metroid game where you start off with all your abilities, and then lose them after the opening sequence. They share the same enemy, but level 1 makes you feel powerful, while level 2 does the exact opposite. It's a great use of juxtaposition. I've said before that this one first level makes Star Wars Shadows of the Empire worth playing, and after analysing it, it's easy to see why. While the game is certainly showing its age, this is a very fun opening sequence that almost perfectly replicates the film it's based on. For an N64 launch title, that's a pretty impressive feat. As I said at the start, it really doesn't represent the full game, so the Battle of Hoth fails to teach the player anything useful, and it sets a very high standard that the rest of the game has trouble living up to. But on the other hand, it creates a fun, memorable opening that lets you immediately get into the action, and motivates you to keep playing. Does that make it a good first level, or not? This time I think I'll let you decide. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you next time.